Good morning and welcome to Channel 48. Today is Sunday, the day after King's Day, and it was a rainy King's Day, but still many of us partied last night and whole day long. People were on the street enjoying all the street shows and the parties and etc. But today I'm back in the studio to show you two fantastic ROMs that you can download, Android 9 ROMs, of course, for your 9505 S4 and family. This will support a bunch of the S4 family models. So there is a team, they are called the GDC team, and the two main developers, Buff and Side, both created their ROMs for this phone. And I'm talking about the latest ROMs. I think the Pixel Experience was created some days ago, and it contains the latest security patches for this Android version. So yeah, in fact, you're kind of good to go. Also, one difference between these two ROMs: one comes with Google services and the Play Store installed, and one comes as a custom ROM without any Google Play Store or anything installed, really light. And that one was made by Side, and Buff created the one that comes with the Google services. Buff also created the AOSP extended version for this phone. Only thing that I found out was that the recent apps, you know, in fact, I could press whatever I wanted on here, but it would not pop up, and I could not close the apps that I, you know, recently used. And in fact, yeah, if that isn't, that part is not really working, then you have a problem, because all these applications will run on the background and you won't be able to close them. So I think, Buff, you still have some work to do on the AEX ROM, the AOSP extended ROM for the S49505 and family. So I'm gonna show you, the first ROM that I'm gonna show you will be the Pixel Experience. For my Dutch people, hello, welcome. And als je ook de S4 9505 international of een ander model hebt van de S4 die supported is, je moet even kijken in mijn descriptie, zie je al die modellen. Als jouw model daartussen zit, dan kun jij dit ook doen. Kun jij ook je S4 updaten naar Android 9. Dat is echt cool voor zo'n oud telefoon. En ja, nou, er zijn twee ROMs die je kunt installeren. Eentje die komt met de Google Play Store. En eentje die geheel light aangeboden wordt zonder Play Store. Daar mag je zelf alles zelf gaan indelen. En ik ga je alle twee laten zien. I'm gonna show both ROMs. So let's get started. Okay, there we are. I installed the ROM from developer Side, and this is Lineage OS 16 optimized. So let's go ahead and install the Pixel Experience. We're gonna go to the recovery mode. As you can see, we can immediately choose in the boot, in the startup or the power off, to boot into the recovery mode. If you don't know how to go into a recovery mode, it's a matter of turning off the phone and then volume up, home, and power. Keep pressing until you see that this little blue light on top of the yellow there also turns on, and then you let go of these three buttons, and then you will get into a recovery mode. You already have Twerp installed, and Twerp you can install from twerp.me. Look up your model and just flash it with Audin in a Windows computer, where you also have the USB drivers installed from Samsung. Remember, if you're still on a stock ROM, you will have to wipe the internal drive as well, meaning that you will lose each and everything on the phone. So make sure to make a backup of your contacts, your pictures, your videos, your music, etc. You know, copy them to a computer, and then you're gonna be good to go. If you already have Twerp installed, well, then you can go ahead and do a wipe. If this is the first time you're gonna install a custom ROM on the phone, you will also wipe the internal storage. In my case, I will not, because For me, it's not needed to do that anymore. Okay, we just wiped and I'm gonna install. And the first ROM that I'm gonna install is the Release 6 Pixel Experience that was created by Buff. And let's go ahead and install it. This version comes with Google Play Store. It's kind of a bit bigger. It's I think 600 and something megabyte. So that is, yeah, for a custom ROM, kind of big. But that's because the Google Play services are also installed. And we're gonna take a look at the ROM itself. I will not flash my mod on top of it yet, okay? Because in my case, I will not install gaps. Because iEffect don't support gaps on custom ROMs. If you want to do that, you have to go ahead and do that yourself. But in this ROM, you won't have to do anything. Because Buff already pushed in the Google Play Store. So that's kind of cool for many of you users. They're always crying for Google Play services. Okay. Remember that Google also don't really want custom ROM users to use the Play Store. Because in fact, yeah, the custom ROM has nothing to do with Google itself. This was independently developed. So yeah, Google is like, hey, you know, find your own apps. They also blocked the custom ROM world at a certain moment from using the Play Store, and we had to go ahead and register our IMEIs at the phone. I'm flashing Magisk now. And Magisk will give us root access on the phone, so we can also use rooted applications. So I'm now gonna start the phone, and I did not flash my mod. I just want to show you what you're gonna get if you only gonna install the ROM. And remember, this ROM was by Buff and GDC team. So GDC team and everyone that worked on the background to make this possible, thank you very much from the Channel 48 studio. And I say great work. So now you might find out that that at a certain point it's gonna take very, very long to start up this ROM. That's what I found out. Okay, it was not really starting up. It never came to the home screen. And in that case, just let it boot for, yeah, 1 or 2 or 3 minutes. And then kick out the battery and turn it on again. And then you're gonna be good to go. Okay? So it's about the time that it will take to start up Android 9 on the S4. And that's about 3 minutes. 2 to 3 minutes. So if you see that after 2 or 3 minutes, this ROM is not, you know, bringing you to the setup startup page, then you will have to kick out the battery and just turn on the phone again. Okay, that's what I found out. But of course, it could be that now it will just go to the setup screen. I don't know. We'll have to see about that. And I'm gonna let you know if that will happen. But just for the good case, I'm gonna let it boot a bit, and we're gonna take a look at the boot up. And the moment we're like, hey, this is taking way too long, just kick out the battery and just restart it again, and you'll be good to go. We also see no little lights changing color there at the top, and that you will see with the optimized ROM. and I've been testing them both already, and I found out that battery life of this ROM is even better than the optimized ROM from Sight. So Sight, I think you still have some work to do on the optimized ROM to kind of optimize battery life, okay? Because battery drain is kind of, yeah. I went to bed with, I think, 63% and played a bit with it, then I fell asleep. And this morning when I woke up, phone was empty. So I think we reached about 3 minutes now. So what I'm gonna do at this point, because you see it's not there yet, it should have been there already. So what you can do is just volume down, power, keep pressing these two until the phone goes off. You see that? And now reboot the phone again. 3 minutes is about the time that you should let it boot. And now it will boot straight up to the setup screen. And we can from there go ahead and set up the phone. And then I can show you the nice Pixel experience created by Buff and GDC team. Not to forget. Very important as well. And there we go, we already know this boot animation. I'm also kind of using it. And now we should be brought to the setup screen. Won't take too long, you see that? So if you don't know this, then you will say, oh, ROM is not booting up, it's not good. You know that while it's very good, nothing wrong with the ROM, but you must, you know, this is a custom ROM, so you must understand how to use it, you know. And now we're gonna go to start up. We can skip. Next. Yeah. Location. Get there enough. Location and send diagnostics. No, and we accept. Up here we can set our password. I will not use that. And there we are. And this is the ROM, guys. And as you can see, Google is represented in here, the Play Store. And I think Google Assistant, you see that? So this is a nice ROM and nice sounds as well. Yeah, I think this is lovely. Lovely ROM. Okay, so go ahead and check it out. So developer site, Buff, great job. Okay. So this is what you can expect. Camera works, everything works, phone calls, etc. It all works. And the phone part looks really nice. I don't even see it. Here. You see that? Very nice, huh? U hebt niet genoeg beltegoed om dit gesprek te voeren. Oh, gesprek geëindigd. That number does not exist. Oh, 800, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Geen genoeg beltegoed om dit gesprek te maken.
Is goed dan, schatje. Ik hou ook van jou. This is my favorite provider. It's called Leica. Leica Mobile. They give free SIM cards. And the coolest is that these free SIM cards, they will give you a number that will always work. Other than Lebara, if you don't put no credits on the SIM, you will still have and keep your number. So that is very cool of Leica Mobile. So Leica Mobile, thank you so much for that, and never change your policy. Always stay the way you are. Okay. Now we're gonna check out another ROM. Opnieuw opstarten. Advanced reboot was not selected yet in developers options, and we're gonna boot up into a recovery mode. You see, you keep holding it until you see the little blue light or line there, and then you let go of the button. Buff also created the AOSP Extended, but the recent apps button is not working, so I cannot shut off applications that are running on the background. So yeah, in fact, I'm not gonna show that ROM. That ROM should be fixed first, okay? I'm gonna wipe everything again, cache, data system, and Dalvik. Now I'm gonna show you the second ROM. This one was created by Sight, and I prefer this ROM even more because it has no Google services installed. And here you can see it. It's called the optimized Lineage OS version 6. This is the latest of Sight. Developer site. Created on the 12th of March. And I remember showing the ROM from, I think, the month before, February, before I left to Suriname. So this is the updated ROM that came after that one. So this one I never showed yet. Lineage OS 16, Android 9, optimized. Very nice. Okay, so what I love about this ROM is that I can as well flash my mod on top of it. But I first want to show you the ROM itself, okay, how you're gonna get it. I'm gonna do that for Sight. So I'm gonna flash my mod after a reboot, after you saw the boot animation that Sight pushed into this ROM, and we're good to go. I installed Magisk for the root, and I'm also gonna connect some power because battery is kind of low. And there we go. As always, we will get a reboot after the first boot up. It will reboot back into the Samsung boot up screen. This is the boot animation that Sight gift to this ROM. Also very nice. You see that? And this is a very light ROM, okay? It's barely naked, nothing installed. You can do it all yourself. This is more for the guys that know how to set up an Android phone, how to get their own applications. This is for people that want to create a custom phone, okay? A phone that is not yeah, depending on Google services. This will be a phone that depends on what you're gonna give to it, okay, and how you're gonna treat it. So that's why I'm also flashing my PEPs. And these are the PUX apps, the P apps, and they contain a firewall and all the tools that I'm using. In fact, as well on my phones, tools that I love to see on my phones, such as Root Browser, great tool. My world radio, my scanner radio, you know, these are all nice little applications to have on your phone, because then your phone can also entertain you. unfortunately NPO, because of the pimping of the public station, they are setting us up with a version that can only be used with the Google Play services. A pity, because they had the old version that was working really good and we used it for many years, but they killed that version and now we can't watch live TV anymore, unfortunately. Something that should not happen with public TV, radio. Radio is still playing, but you know, TV. These guys come with DRM and they come with services must be installed before using our app. All sorts of craziness. And here you're gonna see, we're gonna get into a screen where nothing happens, okay? So the only problem is that what is happening here is that the phone did not reboot. Okay, so just remove the battery and we're gonna manually reboot it again. Okay, remember that we always have this extra reboot after the first boot. It will, you know, reboot again automatically. Well, that automatically did not work. Maybe it was because we also installed the Pixel Experience before this one. Could be anything, because I found out that after installing this version, and I would do a clean install again, it would then automatically boot back into the Samsung logo and then start up the phone and then everything would work. Okay, so these phones are living creatures. So there we go, and this is what you're gonna get. You see that? A lovely, lovely, lovely dark theme that you can also set to black if you wish. In advance. And in, where was it again? In style somewhere here. Style, dark. And black. Wait a second, and there we are. See that? This is the black mode. Lovely. And this ROM, I prefer this ROM because I just love a ROM that comes like really light and without any service installed. So I'm gonna go for this ROM. You will have the possibility to go for them both. I will put both links for you. And the independent users, I think, will love to go for this ROM. I did find that the battery life of this ROM is not so fantastic. But maybe some tweaking could help to make that even better. Okay. So I'm wiping the phone again. You just saw the Pixel Experience from above. And now, effect. What did I do? Oh, that was the Pixel Experience. No, we already installed optimized Lineage OS. I'm gonna install it one more time. And now I'm also gonna install my mod on top of it. My iOS mod. En voor mijn Nederlandse mensen, we zijn Android 9 aan het installeren op de S4, i9505 en familie. Er zijn er een hele hoop. Er zijn verschillende modellen van deze telefoon gemaakt. En wat we gedaan hebben is, we hebben eerst gekeken naar de Pixel Experience van ontwikkelaar Buff. En nu kijken we naar de Optimized Lineage OS. Door ontwikkelaar Site en zijn GTC team natuurlijk. En die zijn we nu aan het installeren. En het is geïnstalleerd. Oké, en we gaan eentje terug. Nu ga ik mijn iOS 13 mod installeren over de installatie. En deze applicaties zullen permanent geïnstalleerd worden. En ik ga installeren Magisk 18. En Magisk 18, dat is om administratieve rechten te krijgen op de telefoon, zodat wij de baas zijn van de telefoon en wij bepalen hoe of wat. En we ook echt dat kunnen doen. Oké, en nou gaan we rebooten. En nu rebooten we in een iOS-lijkende phone. Dit is voor de iPhone-freaks, mensen die ook iPhones hebben en hun Android-telefoon ook er zo willen laten uitzien. Of gewoon hobbyisten die ooit eens een iPhone willen en het nu al willen uitproberen hoe dat werkt. En dit is het welbekende opstartlogo. En opstarttijd is zeer rap, moet ik zeggen, voor deze S4. This is still a S4, but I found out that the boot time is very good. And here you can see that light is flashing several colors. Also nice. Let's charge it a bit. And this is a first time boot. So we're gonna get a reboot back into to the Samsung logo. It's very normal. Still a lovely phone, the Samsung S4. Ik kan me best voorstellen als je deze telefoon nog hebt, dat je denkt van wauw, is toch eigenlijk een hele mooie telefoon. Maar de software waar die op draait, echt waar, is ja, dat maakt die telefoon eigenlijk waardeloos. Hè? Dus ja, als je denkt van ik heb deze telefoon nog en hij ziet helemaal nieuw uit. En ik wil er echt de hoofdprijs voor hebben. Nou, vergeet het maar. Als jij deze telefoon niet weet op te daten naar een betrouwbare Android versie, dan is die telefoon net zoveel waard als een pistool waar je Russische roulette mee speelt. En ja, het gebruik van die telefoon is dan niet echt veilig meer. What I'm saying is, if you still have this phone and it's still running the stock firmware, I think it will be KitKat or so, or maybe even Android 5, then yeah, it's like playing Russian roulette, because the Android version is not safe anymore. And I see many people asking way too high prices for these old phones that are still on Jelly Bean and on KitKat, just because they think that it's a nice phone and because they paid a lot of money for it in the past, you know, and they think that they can still sell it for a high price in 2018 or 19. But yeah, that's just a illusion, because phones being on old firmware is like playing Russian roulette with a gun. And trust me, there are more than one bullet in that thing. So you're gonna shoot yourself. Be careful whatever you do on these kinds of phones. If you're gonna use it to make videos or as a dash cam, you know, then you're good to go on Jelly Bean, you know, even on Gingerbread. But if you really want to use the phone, log in with your Google accounts and with your Facebook, then you will be a victim within hours. Maybe the moment that you connect, you're already becoming a victim. And you know that identity theft is a big problem these days. People, their identity and all sorts of information is getting stolen. I showed you two phones that I bought this week. One I got free after buying the other. because it was not turning on. And when we fixed that phone, we also found out that there was a whole lot of information on the phone. The other one that we bought, the Galaxy Grand Prime, also had all sorts of information of the previous users still on the phone. People are, you know, getting rid of these phones, but they don't know how to clean them up before selling them. So that is also a problem that we find out. And people that sell these phones to people with evil minds, they will get into trouble sooner or later. En dat is erg belangrijk als je ook een oude Android-telefoon hebt, om al jouw gegevens van die telefoon af te halen. Om een wipe data factory reset te doen, een clean install factory, een factory reset, een fabriek terug naar fabrieksinstellingen. En zorgen dat al jouw foto's en al jouw video's en je WhatsApp berichten, etc., dat die er niet meer op staan. Hier gaan we naar de reboot. Dit is heel normaal. This is very normal. What is happening now? Okay. I was waiting for this. And now we will be booted up within 1 minute. Under 1 minute. And there we go. You see that? And there we are already, and we can choose to boot up with Quick Step, but you already saw that one, and now we're gonna go to the iOS launcher always. We give it permission, and even though we're giving it permission here, we can as well block this launcher in the firewall that we also have in here. That will ask for root access, granted. Don't start with turning it on yet, because you might get into a not connecting browser. So first connect to the internet, and then you can go ahead and turn off the internet again, and then you go fix that all. Okay, so you have an APK Pure Store installed now, audio recorder with a mic gain input. It's really cool. Bitdefender antivirus free, that will help you to keep your phone clean. Okay, a podcast player that will help you to download podcasts as well. Bootbox if you want to create your own boot animations. What more? Let me see. Oh yeah, control center that you will have to position to the bottom. And by pulling this all the way to the right, the alpha and the size, making it all small, you will get an invisible pull-up menu here, just the way it should be. Okay. And this is fine. Cancel. By holding down this button, you will get to the recent items, okay? So we have root browser. I think a tool that should be on every custom RAM, because it will help you to browse your internal drive, and you will be able to get into all the sections, copy, paste, delete, etc. You can all do it with root browser, a fantastic tool, okay? Tool that I cannot live without. Scanner radio gives you the possibility to listen to live ATC, but you can also listen to the police and to the marines, etc. Ships, boats coming in. You can all listen with scanner radio. Radio Droid, a fantastic application that I found in F-Droid. And Radio Droid is a world radio that will let you listen to stations all over the world. YouTube app powered by Parafron. And these guys, they are really amazing, because this YouTube app will help you to watch YouTube videos, okay, on a custom ROM. We have NL Live TV Radio, yeah, effect. NPO killed this app. Yeah, I already said that these guys are pimping the public effect. This is a public station. The government pays for this all. But these guys are, they are pimping off the users, and they disabled the live TV part in it, you know, so we cannot watch live TV anymore with this application. And if we want to do that, we must install the version that demands the Play Store to be installed, the Google services. So yeah, in fact, that should not be needed. This is just a public radio and TV station. You know, they should work with each and every app. It's, you know, it's for the public. But these guys are pimping off the public by letting them install DRM codecs, and they must have Play Store and Google services installed before they can use this application. It's a shame that these things can be done by public TV and radio stations. I think that is literally manipulating, affect the public. That's why they don't have too many views. Magisk manager, of course, will give us root. So all credits goes to the boys there at Magisk. The iOS 12 music player, also nice player that you can use locally to listen to your music. Okay, you don't have to connect to the internet. You can block it in the firewall. And you have all sorts of things that you can do. Here, a nice equalizer, a nice player. Yeah, it just looks fine and it works good. Okay. We give it 5 stars. And of course, Grayscale. Grayscale will also ask for root access, root. We granted root. And now, boom, as you can see, we have a nice little Grayscale phone now that will also use less battery. So if you're low on battery, go Grayscale, and then, yeah, in fact, you will be using your phone for many hours longer. Okay, because it does matter on AMOLED screens. This thing has an AMOLED screen. What more? I think that was it. So the rest you can go ahead and install yourself. Of course, we have the APK Pure Store, and the APK Pure Store will let you download each and every application that you can also find in the Google Play Store. So yeah, I think that is really cool, right? Bootbox, I already showed you. That is to create your own boot animations. And yeah, that's it for me. Okay, everything works. Video works. Sound, everything works, your SIM card works. You can make a nice picture, boom, and you can make a nice video, allow. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ta-dum. You find your picture, your video there. Select video player always, so it won't. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. Okay, sound is also reasonable.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
As you can see, sound is kinda on the high side. So what you will do, if you're gonna go to some show, live band or whatsoever, go into the settings of open camera, go to more camera controls, and go to audio control sensitivity and set it to -2. Okay, then probably the sound will not record too loud. Yeah, so that is it for me. I'm gonna keep this ROM for now. Only thing, as I said, battery consumption is, it's a little bit on the high side, okay? It's a little bit on the high side, so I will set the style to black. And I also want to here in style set these green dots to, let's use blue for a change. No, the other blue, this one here, cyan. And now we also have a cyan. You see that if we turn off any nut, little nut, turn on battery saver, then we can turn it on. You see how nice it looks? I'm just gonna set it like this. And yeah, so that is my only worries a bit, and that is battery life. So side, let me know what the users can do to fix battery life of this ROM. Okay, so I'm gonna charge it fully and then I'm gonna test it again and see how good or how bad battery life is of this ROM. I can say that battery life of the Pixel is really good. I'll be right back. That's right, I think battery life of the Pixel experience from Buff is even better than the optimized Lineage OS 16 from Sight. But I will have to test it again and, you know, check it out and see if it will get any better after doing some tweaks. I will install kernel editor or so, and then I will see if I can, you know, do some little changes in there that will improve battery life. To Sight, I want to say thank you for creating this ROM, as well to Buff. Great job. Buff, remember, the AOSP experience ROM has no recent app button. You cannot get to the recent apps and you cannot turn them off. So that's why I did not show that ROM. I think it need to be fixed first. But that is also a very, very beautiful, beautiful ROM with an amazing boot animation that you should really see. So you can experience that as well. But for me, it's still gonna be the optimized Lineage OS, just because I love the way my apps are running on this ROM. I love everything of this ROM. Only, yeah, battery life, it's not that great. So I think most of you out there will go for the Pixel experience. If you still want the iOS look and feels, just flash my mod on top of the Pixel experience ROM, and then you're gonna have the same thing that you see here, only with one big difference: Google Play Store will be installed. So that was it. I hope you liked this video. It was a long one, but I had to show them both so you have an idea of what you will get. So once again, GDC team, thank you very much, all that worked on this project, thank you, and love to see you, and of course read all your comments about your experience with these two ROMs. Let me know which one you will install, and let me know if it's any good there for you. I want to thank you for watching. Hope you liked this video. If you did, leave it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you did not already. Don't forget to hit the notification bell. Otherwise, you know, you won't ever hear from this channel again. That's just how it is here on YouTube. People that don't ring that bell, they don't get a little update, a message whenever we upload a new video. So subscribing is not enough. The subscribe button, in fact, is, yeah, it's not doing what it should do. Voor mijn Nederlandse mensen, dit was het. Ik hoop dat u genoten hebt van deze aflevering van Android 9 op uw Samsung S4. Als u dit een leuk filmpje vond, moet u even abonneren. Vergeet niet het belletje ook nog te klikken, want anders zult u waarschijnlijk nooit meer een update krijgen van mijn kanaal. En ik lood elke dag video's op, soms andere soort films, maar ik upload elke dag, bijna elke dag. Dus wil je geïnformeerd worden over mijn uploads, vergeet niet dat belletje te klikken. Thank you for watching. Next video will take a look at Android Pie 4, of course, the Samsung Galaxy S5, the G900F. Until then.